Hello guys, today is our blood donation day.
Hello, good afternoon guys. We are here in Latifa Hospital. We are going to give blood. So this is their area. This is from Dubai Health Authority. This is the outside place. And then you can see here, maging isang bayani from the Philippines, and then other translations from India and Arabic translation as well. Be the hero, save lives. So we're going inside.
Hello, what's up guys? We are going inside already. So first thing that we did was to register. They will only need your Emirates ID and then you're good to go. There will be pre-assessment questionnaires prior to donating blood.
This is to know that you are eligible as a blood donor.
Before starting the procedure, there will be hemoglobin test to check your hemoglobin level. Normal levels are 14 to 17 grams per deciliter for men and 12 to 15 for women. In my case, I was 15 and so it was within the level, and we continued the procedure. There will also be blood pressure after that.
Lagi po sila nag-donate noon sa kahit sa Pinas.
During the donation process, the nurse will tell you to be seated comfortably and then will pressure cuff to make veins more visible. In my case, I had a pretty small veins on both sides. But after putting pressure, my veins on my right arm was more visible rather than my left side. She started cleaning my veins by antiseptic and inserted a brand new sterile needle for the blood draw. It just feels a quick pinch and the pain is over for 5 seconds.
Thank you.
In this scenario, I'm about to give 450 ml of my blood, which will usually take about 10 to 15 minutes. I was also asked to squeeze a soft tool to make sure the blood keeps flowing fast. It's crazy that you can see your blood literally flowing into a clear bag, which will eventually help and can save lives of 3 to 4 persons. And guys, did you know? Everyday blood transfusions all over the world can save many people. Donating blood can help in treating patients suffering from cancer, bleeding disorders, and many more. It is important to know that human blood cannot be manufactured because people are the only source of it, and that is why it is important to donate blood and help those who need it. As you can see, blood samples are separated as well. The blood will be tested for hepatitis, syphilis, HIV, and etc. So what happens to the donated blood? It is used to treat patients. A small part of the donation may be used for blood quality testing or stored for future, and it can also be used for research. If any of these tests show positive results, your blood will not be used, and you will be contacted and be given a report.
Also
receive the result. No, if you want to
know the result, you can call our call center number 800-333. Just sit here.
Of course, as you can see, my sister will be donating hers as well. She has been donating way back since 2013 during her college days in UP Manila. Ever since we came here in the UAE, she's been wondering how to donate here. Good thing Dubai Health Authority has a good blood donation system, which is really commendable. To be honest, I was really hesitant at first because of the big needle, you know?
Dalawang galon na, dalawang ganito.
Dalawang dito. 450. Isang masabi.
Isang ganito yun, dalawang ganyan.
350 lang ata. Dito
450.
Kasi 3-way yung sa atin eh. Ito, 4-way bag, 3-way bag yun. So yun, pag dinivide mo, dalawa lang ang pwedeng transfusion. Ito, tatlong tao yan.
At sa 6 yung nasisave niyong buhay.
1:3 dito.
Nak, dalawang ganyan, no? Pukulin sa inyo.
Sa Red Cross?
Sa
Quezon City? Sa Red Cross?
Hindi po, doon po sa UP, Manila po. So, may
PGH
po.
PGH? PGH, yeah. Under na Red Cross po? Ang sa atin, ang license, Red Cross.
O, Red Cross lang po
nga. Actually, magandang blood bank natin yung ano sa Quezon City, malaki. Ang problema kasi, sa atin, hindi hinahawa ka ng government.
So, how often can you give blood? A blood donor can give blood every 56 days.
Kasi para makikita mo kung saan quality, isang department lang ang hahabulin mo.
Hawak ni Gordon.
Under ng government. Dapat Gordon. Yung petition, Gordon, isa lang ang humawak. And like yung sa atin, any hospital nag-extract ng dugo, nag-go-blood kayo. Then binibenta, di ba?
Blood.
Actually, dapat yun, hawakan ng government.
Oo nga.
gobyerno natin. Para yung quality niya, ma-preserve nila yung standard.
Gobyerno talaga, gobyerno.
Kahit saka pumunta, kami pa lang din yun. Meron, Sarja. First state meron. Sarja. Pero makikita ko yung bus nila pumupunta sa Sarja, kami pumupunta din sa ibang lugar. As long as ang nakasulat sa bus, DHA, MOH, Sarja, MOH, DHA, Dubai. Pero, lahat yun, government na gumawa.
Kung tao pala makakaano na, matutulungan na.
So, as you can see, we are now at 281 ml. This time, I'm getting really dizzy. This time, I told the nurse that I was really dizzy and I feel like I'm fainting. She let me lay down for a moment, and the other guy also handed me a drink.
Just watch it, just lie down. You can put down your mask, eh. Baba mo lang mask. It's okay. Bigyan mo na lang muna yung salamin mo sa tatay mo. Baka mag-sa. It's not.
Okay, take a deep breath. Mouth. Okay?
Okay lang kung nakakaramdam ka lang, ano? Baba mo din mask.
They can't have minimum
meter. It's not. Just pull this one. That's not. I can't get out of this. That's why I told you. Anyway, she's almost done.
Just stay here. Yeah.
So what are the possible side effects in donating blood? There's usually no discomfort while giving. A small number of donors may feel faint, dizzy or nauseated, feel tired for a day or two, have bruising or redness at the needle side.
Ah,
This time, I reached 450 ml already. The whole process took about 40 minutes, as I can remember. I still feel dizzy after. That's why I rested for a while. After you give, you should put pressure on the needle site for about 5 minutes to stop the bleeding.
Orange.
12, so bata taas. Yung kanina parang sayot po.
2.
Ano? Picture na po. Itong top yung bina.
Binakulay-bilag pong...
Ate.
Ano ka magkakay?
Sabi ko, pinapot na ka. Ayaw mo eh.
Hindi, okay na po yun.
Oo, wala na yan. Ano? Ang pinapit-pita? Meron na yan. Mother afraid, no? Mother afraid, no?
$383.
$391.
Hey, ka pa? Okay, ako tayo. Dinapper lang bago ka. Malayas, punta ka sa akin, ha? Sige, na aking bili mo. Is he okay? Is he?
Kailan ako yung mga kamag-anak ni paring karating sa Manila nun. Pagka walang pera, ako sa Red Cross na malapit din yun. Oo. Sila Kuya Ronnie. Ang tanong, bibenta ka ganun, panginan.
Bibenta na yung liver.
Malapit anak, 46 na. Yun, malapit ka na. Last 2 minutes. Boom! Malay nga, porta. Kamu kasi ano, yung si yung artista, yung nagkaganon? Hindi, yung may matulis. Oo. Aray, you look like Wolverine, no? You know Wolverine? The actor, no?
The actor.
Look like, maybe you're a Wolverine.
Maybe you're a Wolverine.
You know what I mean, huh?
Yeah.
So all in all, my sister and I are happy that we decided to donate blood, which can hopefully save lives. Maging isang bayani. Encouraging everyone to do the same if possible. Ever since the pandemic has begun, there's a shortage of blood donation. It is important to donate now more than ever. We can help in our own little ways, especially now that we are in trying times. Please let us help each other and make the world healthy and safe. It was really nice sharing this journey with you. Take care and keep safe, guys.